So I just set this to record, and it looks like they gave us some information here. They say that set A has 30 elements. So people say that number of elements in set A is 30. Then also set B with 18. So number of elements in B is 18. And then five elements are in common, means in their overlap, so belong to both or to their intersection. A intersect B is five. Okay, so question is, how many will be in a union? So the formula that we saw was a number of elements in a union is equal to the sum of both sets A and B, right? So if you are looking at the union, so you take set A, everything from A, and then if you take everything from B, then you're gonna have these elements twice because they belong in here and there. So you don't want them to be twice utilized. So you subtract one of the intersections. So this way you're gonna get the whole thing, the actual union of both of those sets in here, right? So to get union, you make sure you don't repeat the elements twice. And that's why you, when you take all A and add it with entire B, it means that you already repeated intersection once and once again. So you subtract this intersection once. So that was 18 actually. Subtract five. And that's how you get the answer. So it looks like it'll be something like 43. And that's the answer that I think everyone produced, right? So that was very good. And well, I guess we'll keep working with sets, and I plan to move to the next section that actually deals with more Venn diagrams. And those Venn diagrams are using now three sets. So it gets a little bit longer.
Professor, can you do the 65, please?
Yes.
Just make sure if I did correctly. Thank you.
65 first. That's a good idea. So in this problem 65, they want you to actually get also a little bit more complicated setting. So let us look at it closer. It says, how about if you take intersection of two sets, intersection, and then take a union with a complement of B. So how would they want us to deal with it? Well, I think the exercise refers to the information here on the previous column. So I guess I need to know the ingredients of all that, and B complement or not B is something that I can start with. So not B will have elements. Looks like we already have here B, right? And then G, and then H. So these are the elements from universal set that already occupied by B. So whatever is left over will be called as a complement. So it's a A, C, D, E, and F, right? So I should prepare this before I start with my procedure of finding, first of all, the intersection of sets A and B. So when I try to find the intersection, oops, what am I doing? And that's my favorite picture that I really love to make again and again. So the intersection will be this common portion called A intersect B. So I need to see what is common in both, and in A and in B. It looks like I see GH. Let me write it a little bit more carefully. So GH, and here, and here. So the intersection of a pair of sets A and B will consist of G and H. So these two are elements of the intersection. And now I need to take the union of that set together with the other one, right? So I need to take a B complement in that A intersect B and produce a set from both of those. So I usually take the first set, let's say GH, entirely, and then see what else needs to be added here from the second set. And I can see that second set is completely separate from intersection of A and B. So I just need to put in all of the elements from that B complement. So I go G, E, and F, and that'd be it. So it looks like we have found the union of those two sets. So whenever we look for the union, we make sure we don't repeat the same elements if they happen to be in both sets. But in this particular example, there was no common part here. So we just put everything together. And some people can say, Alex, maybe you should put them in the alphabetic order like A, C, D, E, F, and then G, H. It doesn't matter. It'd be the same set. If you start to rearrange elements in your set, well, nothing's gonna change. It'd still be the same thing. So the answer is here. I'm very happy that you are doing this homework and that you're current on it. That's great. We just keep working on it. And again, if any other questions, then please let me know. We'll do it together. So I guess I'm gonna move to the next section and do more of these. You will see same, pretty much same exact story that appears again in front of us. But now there'll be three sets, A, B, and C. So they actually produce some pictures for us here. So someplace, let me see. Here it is. It gets a little bit more complicated. So it looks like that we are dealing with sets intersection for all three of them, and that's a dark blue. See, that's the part that belongs to all three sets, A and B and C. But there are also parts that belong only to two of them. Like, for example, if you have this piece here, piece number four, it's just the intersection of B and C, but no A. A is not there. So just common part of only B and C without A. And that's what they say here for the set they call as a Roman numeral four. So they say it's just B, C, and then no A. So it's like A complement. And analogously, they are considering the others, the other intersections. They highlight them with a light blue. And then there are also parts of the sets that belong only to those, not to any other, like a three, for example, here. That's the part that only belongs to set B, but there is no other set. So they just show it like that. So they say the complements of B and C. But I guess from the picture, it's much more obvious compared to looking at this algebraic things. You will look at it and say, what does this mean? Well, when you look at the picture and you see that region three, you say right away, oh yeah, I can see what is going on. So that's why this Venn diagram idea is very, very useful. And I guess today we'll just practice to deal with three sets at the same time. So maybe I can just look at the exercises. You can see they get quite messy, right? So we can do a couple of problems here just to see that it's nice and new. It's the same old stuff, but well, there is more in terms of more sets being involved. So I'm gonna look at first exercises in here and try to make sense of what is happening here. So I'm gonna maybe start with exercise number one that says, what about if you take a intersection of a B with a C? So these two sets that we have here, B and C, and then take a union with E. And it turns out the question is pretty much same as we just did in the previous section, the one that you asked. So it's the same story. You wanna do this step by step. So once I identify what is common part in the sets B and C, and looks like they have two common elements, two and three, right? Two elements in common. So let me write them, two common three. So there are two elements that belong N to B and to C at the same time. Then when I put a union of this with a set A, I need to just pay attention what's in A and in a set that we just produced at the same time. It looks like I see here only one element in common, right? Let me, I just messed it up a little bit, so it's two and three. So there is element three, right? That appears in both of them. So that's why I should be careful with that three, so I don't wanna use it twice. So I'm gonna list my entire A as usual, 1, 3, 5, and 7. And then I will add element two to it, but not three, because three is already present, so I just put a two in there, and that's about it. So again, once you know the ingredients, then you can always get whatever is needed. Just step by step, little by little. Don't try to do the whole thing at once. Just a little piece, another little piece, another little piece, and the answer will come out right away. Let me try one more here with this sets exercise number 12 that talks about the union of sets B and C, but not just the union, they wanna take a complement of that union. Well, I will start with a union because next step I'll do the complement. So when I look at union B and C, once again, I know there are two common elements, so I don't want to use them twice. So I'm going to put entire B, like a 1, 2, and 3, right? And then 2 and 3 is not what I want to take again, because I already have 2 and 3. So when I deal with a C now, I skip 2 and 3 because they're already present, and just add what is missing, which is 4, 5, and 6. So this will be my union of sets B and C, right? And then the next step will be to take its complement. So what will be the complement? So if I take the union of these two guys and say, no, what's not in that union? What from my universal set is not present? And I can see only one element not present, element 7. Do you see it? Element 7 is the only one missing because 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6, we already have in the union. So not in the union is a 7. And that's it. So once I know my sets that I have to deal with here, so I know one set is 7 and the other set is 8, then I can answer their question. I can see what will be in their overlap, what will be in their intersection. It looks like there is only one common element here. It's just a 7, and that's it. So looks like 7 belongs to and set A and to the one that I just produced in here, because that set has only one 7 in it, which makes life even easier. So these problems are not really hard, but they just have more steps and one needs not to hurry. So look at the next page here and I see those pictures that we have given. So I can take a look at the exercises related to the picture here. I think they make a good sense. It's a Venn diagram. So let me clear some room for this. Actually, let me clean everything here. So stop it and share it again like that. And I'll try to do exercise number 33 that says, how about if you list all elements of the set A? That's what the roster form actually means. So you just list all elements of the set A, which is right here, right? So what does it have? Well, it looks like it has elements 1, 2, 3 here, 4, 5, 6, and then 7 and 8, right? So there'd be lots of elements in this set. 4, 5, 6, and also 7 and 8. So I just want to make sure that everything that belongs to A is considered. And I considered 4 pieces, right? There was the white piece, there were 2 light blue and 1 dark blue that had element 6 only. So looks like that's the way to go. So let me try something like exercise number 43. So, oh, there's some kind of complement. Yeah, so remember we looked at the common part of all 3 sets. That was this portion, right? Common part of all 3 sets is right here. So that's the intersection of A, B, and C. I can even write it down. A intersect B, intersect C, that has only one element, 6. The dark blue, right? So what they want is to list all the elements that are on the outside. Everything that is not in the dark blue, and that means just everything that is here except for number 6, right? So what would that everything going to be then? Maybe I'll list it here on the left. There's not enough room. There's lots of stuff. And I look at the numbers here and they seem to start at 1 and go all the way through 16. So I go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, no 6, 6 is already taken. So it goes 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. Ooh, finally, that's a lot of elements. But that's everything that is not in the intersection. And this is it. So I guess the pictures, those that we call as Venn diagram are probably the nicest that we can think of, because this is really intuitive solution for all of these problems. So let us try problem like 53 here, which is a little bit different because it doesn't have the elements, but it just talks about the sets. So they want to think of complement of A union B. What does that mean? Well, I know what union of two sets A and B is, right? We already saw this so many times, so I can write this again. So this is going to be everything that is covered by those two sets. Okay, so what if I try to take a complement of A and then take a union of B? How does that going to look like? Well, for complement of A, so if my first set is A, I'm going to need to use everything outside of A. Right? Everything outside of A, that's a complement. And then when I'm looking at the set B, then to take a union, I need to take everything that belongs to either one or the other set. So please notice that there is a little extra that I need to add here, and this will be the common part. So it looks like this is going to be the set that they're talking about in my first piece. And then they also talking about the intersection. So the second piece, now the second part of this exercise will be dealing with A intersect B complement. So let me come up with that set. And again, first I'm gonna get my favorite example of intersection of two sets. So that'd be a common part of those sets like that, right? A intersect B is right here. So whatever is in both of these sets at the same time. So what's going on now? Well, now I need to see what is N in a set A and not in a set B. So this means not B. And I think this is going to be here. That's the part that belongs to the set A, but does not belong to the set B. So now the question is, are these two the same? And one can say they're not the same, right? They're not equal. In fact, they're like opposites to each other because the first one takes inside of that piece and the second takes everything on the outside, right? So nothing inside, but everything on the outside. So they're actually complements. So if you try to take a complement of first, it'll be the second. Or if you take complement of second, it'll be first. So they're opposites. So they say, are they equal? And you say, no, not equal. Well, that makes it be a little bit on the tedious side, right? So I would say this group of exercises is not as much fun as one may just have in the previous problem. So I would say that this part of the section will be already a little bit too much. So you can do your homework up to problem 48, and you don't have to worry about the rest because it starts to be way, way too much, and I don't think we ever gonna care and use it anywhere. That's why it's already too much for us. So we can just try to do problems from previous exercise groups. And I think a good question for a little quiz for today will be do problem number 34. I think it's very similar to the problem I just did 33. So Can you do for a quiz exercise number 34? That says, list all elements in the set B. So I can help you. I can just highlight B like that. So all you need is just list all of its elements. And that'd be our quiz for today.
Professor, can you scroll up?